I love the most. I play all the Schumann distances. Think, oh, yes, in the Rochester, without music.
Isn't that interesting?
Yes. That no people don't
no
know.
No music.
It. No people don't know it.
When you're preparing, let's say, for last week's concert or any other concert, do you spend much time practicing for a concert like that? I mean, you know the work.
Well,
you don't...
To learn the work like Schumann this one, right. The one I have to practice. But, you know, not in hours.
No.
But in days.
Right.
You see, I believe that if you practice too long time and you repeat mechanically difficult places of music, you
right.
know, which are not in hand and you want to make it clear that every finger is even, if you repeat it all the time and finally you do it, it becomes mechanical, and you repeat 100 times at home and you go on the stage, you repeat it 100 first time. It becomes mechanical. So I believe, and I like brushing the teeth, you know. I believe to do it every day, but not too long. I don't practice more than 1 hour and a half. Never. But I never miss a day.
You do?
Never miss a day.
In this 1 hour and a half, is it drill or is it music?
Music. Music and then drill too.
Do you do
but
drill?
But I find it in music.
I see.
In any music you find the drill, you know. But I will not do some time, maybe 10 minutes, I do my own exercise. I never do something like this, calisthenics, just to warm up circulation of the hands, you know. And then I start to work something. And it makes no difference if it's a slow piece or fast piece. You have to work in slow pieces. You know, it reminds me of the anecdote. And the Rachmaninoff told me that when Moritz Rosenthal, as a young man, he was a tremendous mechanic. You know, he had a mechanic. Everybody in Vienna, the Leschetizky, you know, he gave every Friday or Saturday always all the pupils of Leschetizky met and they play. And he was playing his Papillon and his things, and everybody, my God, he was. And somebody asked him to play some romance of thing. Yes, and he plays, Rachmaninoff was saying, he plays everything, you know, the drop of perspiration, nothing, just like nothing. So they asked him to play something slow, something melodic. So he started to play, he started to perspire. That's very funny. He started to perspire every drop was in the nose.
That's funny.
That's true.
Morris Rosenthal, of course, was famous in a New York gym. They have a portrait of Morris Rosenthal. And
he was like
a weightlifter.
Weightlifter.
He was only known as a weightlifter in this gym. They didn't know him as a pianist.
He was a circus man, like.
That's funny. Well, I have that feeling, for example, when you play some of the small works in the Kinder scene. More difficult than
it is to hold that in.
Yeah.
You see, this is for this room.
Exactly.
It's not for 3,000-4,000 people. But they're so touching, you know, because it's touching music.
Oh yeah.
You know? It's very, yeah.
Very, very,
very moving. Yeah. Moving.
You do some drill, but I remember William Capel used to practice loud. And Cherkasky used to practice very soft. Do you practice, do you take a line on that? Do you practice heavy or do you practice soft?
I practice usually loud.
Usually loud?
Usually loud, because then it's easier to play soft in my playing.
Right.
But that is my conception, that's not for everybody. You see, I use different kind of touch for soft playing or for hard playing. For soft playing, you see the finger slide this way.
Right.
You see? For hard playing, the...
Like a hammer.
The hammer, you know.
Right.
But from here, not from there. From there, you see? So that you have to develop. And this then developed is better when after you hit like this, that developed nicely.
And yet,
you
Mr.
Harvey... press the key.
And yet... when piano teachers watch your television program, when they watched you play, they all said he's breaking all the rules.
Yeah, they did because I, no, but no, sometime.
Yeah.
Because I play every work different, but even my wife told the last time. Said that each composer you play, you play the, your fingers sometimes curved, sometimes they're like flat,
right.
Sometimes they're like that, but it depends what you play.
Years and years ago, there were music journals that used to carry advertisements by doctors, by surgeons, who were aiming their interests to young musicians, young pianists, who had technical problems. And they said they could correct their technical problems through surgery, separating the fingers entirely, so they're completely independent of one another. You don't seem to have any problems. Your fingers seem to be totally independent of each other.
I must tell you, there are sometimes they are so friendly, so inseparable. It's not always like that. Then I suffer. So friendly. They just refuse to go away from each other. but that happens. So you work and then so finally you separate them.
It's interesting to know that you have problems.
Sure, I have problems. Everybody has problems. You have problem walking. No, I walk every day 2 miles.
Really?
Every day. If I don't walk 1 or 2 miles, 1.5, depending on weather. Only when it's too hot, then I'm a little slow. Always, ever. Today I did 40 blocks, which is 2 miles, every day.
When you, for example, this independence of the fingers, for example, the last movement of the Emperor Concerto, the opening, there's a trill on the top.
Yeah.
I think you're probably the only pianist I've ever heard where I can hear that trill.
Because you see, there is a secret in trill. The faster you play the trill, the less you hear the notes. If you play even and a little slower, it makes impression that you play fast. If you play, you don't hear it.
Right.
In some terrific, you know, mechanic, they play fast, but it doesn't. But you play. Oh my God! You see. It's even every note. But you have trills in the rondo of that Chopin. Lots of small technique. It's an interesting piece, by the way.
Yes, and it's not played.
Not played, but it's a very nice piece.
Beautiful, beautiful.
But very difficult, you know. There's lots of fingers there.
If you could redesign your hand, what would you do?
Redesign?
Yeah.
It's not so big. My hand is not big. It's normal.
But you can comfortably take a tenth?
Not comfortable, but I take it. But it's not a big hand.
No.
No.
If you could change it in any way, how would you change it? Enlarge it?
No, I don't want to have larger hand, no.
No.
Then it is difficult to play chromatic things and things like that, you know. Serkin had very thick finger. Yeah, thick. He has one finger like my tooth, nearly. You see, my fingers are not. And that makes different touch for itself. See, it's the nature. You cannot change yourself.
You
one,
can
I have a big
go.
Nose, another I have a small nose. What can you do?
You, I don't believe, have been to Europe in many, many years.
Who?
You have
yes,
not played
now,
in Europe for...
From 51 I was last time. And only in 2 towns, Paris and London. But now I am prepared.
Uh-huh.
You know, they have even the whole 2 days in London. For me in June, but I still decide not to go this year. Because I work lots this winter already. So, not that I don't have stamina, I could go. But I'm more interested, you know, to play Mettner or something, find another piece of something for next year, like Schumann and things like that, play something. I need time for that. I need 3-4 months, you know. Because I'm not a worker who sits 6-7 hours per day and play. Yeah, I don't believe in that. I don't believe in that. I think you get tired and you play worse and worse with every hour.
You've never had a disaster on the stage. You've never had a disaster during a performance where you have to stop.
What kind of disaster?
Well, for example, I know some pianists who have literally stopped in the middle of a performance. because things were not going well?
I have sometimes thing broken. I had
tape come off the finger.
Yeah. You see, I took it as a precaution, not to have a blue, from heat. Because when you had the blue, then you cannot play. So I put the tape, but the tape, half of it, and it was floating. For 1 minute, I was off. You know, I didn't know where I am. And so I didn't have time. So many notes there. So finally, I find the pose, and I do the maybe 10 seconds more, and just click, and then I continue. It's first time it happens to me, but it happens here.
This is a little blood blister that you didn't want to have.
Yeah. Blood bluster, that's what I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Because with blood bluster, then you cannot play 2-3 weeks
that.
And I take it as a precaution. I don't have it anything, you see. Is everything all right? But only those two. That for me is two most important fingers.
The fifth finger.
Fifth finger of both hands.
Yeah. Carry the melodies.
Yeah, the carry melody and harmony.
Right.
Here is the harmony, here is the melody. And that has to come.